So good morning everyone. So today topic is personal training and transport of lab animals. So basically in this we'll study like what are personal trainings. This selection of animal facility staff and particularly the staff working in animal room should involve in transportation. Or involved the staff involved in transportation is a critical component in the management of animal facility. The staff must provide all the requirements of protective clothing, mask, aprons, gloves, gum boots and other footwears etc. while working in animal room, because it is very much important to maintain the personal hygiene there, and also like it is very much important to maintain the personal hygiene of the worker and also the animals, because they can get any infection from the worker, and it is essential that the animal care staff maintain a high standard of personal cleaning. Like they should frequently change their uniforms while entering one room to another animal room, and also like they should change their footwears. And also before entering the animal room they should get a shower. So these things are very much important, and facilities should be provided for changing over with lockers, wash basins, toilets and bathrooms to maintain the personal hygiene. So, and it is also very much important to get a regular medical checkup, because sometimes we can also the individual working there at animal husbandry can get infection from the animal. So it is very much important for the individual to get completely vaccinated, and because there is sometimes there are zoonotic infections which we can get from the animals or the person who's standing there or doing the animal handling, so he can also get the infection. So next point is like the animal house in charge should ensure that the person working in the animal husbandry should not like drink or eat smoke in the animal room, because it is very much important. That can give stress to the animal for like after that they can get anxiety or they can have depression. A few weeks must be spent on like if the person is recruiting new in the animal house, so first of all he should spend some training time before properly handling the animal, because animal should also get comfortable to the person who's working there, because they get easily stressed or they get depressed by seeing new individuals. So and they should also be made familiar with the activities of normal health and sick animals, so they can be able to spot the sick animals during their daily routine and checkup of the cages. So next comes the transportation of laboratory animals. The transportation of animals from one place to another is very much important and must be undertaken with care, because it plays a major role while transporting. They should not feel stress and they should not feel very much congested. They should like move properly in their cage, should have enough space. So these are very much things should be taken care of. So, and the main consideration for transportation of animals are the mode of transport, the containers, the animal density in the cage. Like they should not keep like more than one or two animal in one cage, because it can make them fight or they can injure themselves or they can get infection from one animal to other. So these should be taken care of. And also the climatic conditions plays a major role, like in a rainy day or this. So temperature or climatic conditions should be taken care of before traveling, transporting them from one place to another, because it varies from species of animal, different. So, and also the animal can be transported by road, rail, or air, taking into consideration of their transportation, their containers. There should be not much animal density, the density of the cage. So these should be taken care of. And in any case, the transportation stress should be avoided, and the container should be of an appropriate size so that they can move comfortably. They can have a free movement, and they can be protected from the outer environment, and should not have some possible injuries. So, and food and water should be also kept there, because if it is a long journey, so they'll feel hungry. So, if they'll feel hungry, they can be aggressive sometimes. So, this should be taken care of, and this should be taken care of. The transport container's cage should be of appropriate size, and only a permissible membrane of animal should only be accommodated in each container to avoid overcrowding and unfitting, because it is it plays a major role. They can feel suffocated sometimes. So these are some cage of rodents, and in these pictures shown, small cage, big cage. So these are my references. Thank you so much.